friends of the narcissist to your enemies. You might think these people are your friends, they might say they are your friends, but if they are friends of the narcissist, they are not yours, they are your enemies. The narcissist will use these so-called friends as their flying monkeys to do their bidding. They will smear your name. With most people there is nothing to light the smear campaign, so they will just make up complete lies. Truth doesn't matter to the narcissist, fact does not matter to those without a conscience. They will twist and deceive to achieve their goals. And their goals always end in destruction. The narcissist is powerless on their own because they are an empty shell. They are cowards, they would never face you on their own unless they were bigger and stronger than you. Narcissists are too cowardly to have a fair fight. So they must recruit an army of their own. Because if there is a large group of people against one person, all defending the narcissist, then they know they are safe from direct consequences. The narcissists are beacons of evil. They go from person to person bringing destruction. But they have so much experience in manipulation, the people they dupe into being their flying monkeys don't even see past their mask. These people might be well-intentioned people away from the narcissist, but probably not. What I have learned from experience is if there is an evil person in a group of people, is evil too. The rest of the group might not be overtly evil, but they do the evil bidding of the narcissist without question. So if there is a narcissist in a group of people, there is only one thing to do: run. They have to surround themselves with enablers to stroke their egos and be their own personal army to destroy anyone that knows them for what they are. The narcissist will make you their enemy for the silliest of reasons. Narcissists are control freaks, so if you do not bend to just one of their demands, well, you might as well have murdered their entire family. That is how much the narcissist blows things out of proportion to justify their evil. This is what they say to their flying monkeys. They say you have murdered their entire family when all you've done drop a speck of dust on an already dirty floor. And the flying monkeys will believe them, either because it suits their own personal needs or they are just stupid. The narcissist will offer them all kinds of benefits for being their evil minions. But there is no prize too great to cost you your soul. The narcissist cannot have anyone too intelligent to be their evil minions, or they would catch on to their ruse. Or the narcissist will keep them in such an echo chamber that they will believe whatever they want. The narcissist uses people against each other, and although they wouldn't know it, it is ultimately for the worse for them. It reminds me of that Stephen King story called Needful Things. I have only seen the movie, so don't hold it against me. So this man comes into a peaceful town and starts offering up all kinds of trinkets personalized to each person. These trinkets happen to be what they want most. He is a very friendly and charismatic man, people immediately like him. He gives away these items for free, but nothing is really free, is it? As for the cost for keeping these items, the man demands that these nice people do their bidding. He weaves his spiel, convincing them that it is not bad. These people end up sabotaging their fellow townspeople, threatening, hurting and murdering people. And when looked at from a distance, it looks like these people murdered each other, but really it was this man that was the puppet master behind it all. Eventually someone else catches on to what this man is doing. They confront the evil man and start trying to tell people. The people say, "No, he couldn't possibly be a bad person, he is so kind. He is friendly and he gave me this item." By trying to expose this evil man, the person then makes themselves look bad and the minions of this evil man turn against him. The story does have a good ending in that they eventually realize what he is and run him out of town, where he is left to be the puppet master of evil in another town. But this does not usually happen with the narcissist. These people are so invested in the narcissist that they have so much riding on this person that they couldn't accept it even if they were smacked in the face with the facts. Instead, they will turn against you for stating the facts about this person, instead of accepting the truth. They will immediately lash out at you for the notion that this evil person they are helping is a bad person. Unbeknownst to them, the narcissist will turn against them the first chance they get. Because these people are tools, the narcissist doesn't care about them. They will destroy their minions' lives when it is advantageous to them. So if you have been hurt by the narcissist and their minions, you can be comforted by the fact that either this narcissist or another one will turn against the minion that did you so much wrong. Thank you for watching. Subscribe to the channel for more videos. To get personal support, look in the video description, and you can support new videos too.